God calling each one of us, because the enemy, as Jesus himself said in Matthew's Gospel chapter 11 verse 12 onwards, from the days of John the Baptist, the gifts and life that I have given to my children are being stolen away by the enemy. And the enemy takes it away with the violence. And so many of my children who have received, who are endowed with the mighty power and presence of God, they lose everything and they die miserably. Judas, a chosen vessel of God, hangs and dies. Yes. Jonah, a mighty anointed servant of God, he is being left out. On the way, he drowns in the water. We know various step up. Peter, who is supposed to go to meet the master, he ends up with few women taking care of his flesh, betraying the Lord and running away from the Lord and never coming back to meet the Savior even for a minute, though the Savior was hanging on the cross for 6 long hours. Peter did not come even for a minute to meet the Lord. What the enemy can do to the children of God are horrible if you and I are not alert. The enemy is roaring like a lion. Though God has kept so many blessings for each one of us, he takes it away by taking us away from the presence of God, which we call it sin. Sin means basically taking us away from God, taking us away from the love and the presence of the Father. Yes. As long as we are in the presence of the Father, no problem. The presence of the Father will take care of us. Because the Bible says, 1 John 5:12, he who has the Son has the life. He who doesn't have the Son doesn't have the life. Yes. That's why we read in 1 John chapter 5 verse 4. He who is born of God overcomes everything. He is moving with the presence of God. How did the prodigal son who was living in the mighty love of the Father is being taken away? By sin. Sin implies that taking away the eyes of man and the woman from the eyes, from the presence of the Father, and to fix it on something in the world, in the flesh, in that which is perishing, that which leads us to perishing. Sin is the trick of the enemy, which the enemy successfully executes in the lives of people, from taking away the eyes of the children of God from God the Father to God of this earth. Sin basically means taking man from that which is eternal, life-giving, to something that is perishing, and making him to believe that, and make man to get entangled with that and move away from the presence of the Father. In the mathematics we say, from 0 you go 5, 10, 15, 20. But the other side we find, from 0 you go minus 5, minus 10. So it moves from down to down to down. So those who are enjoying the presence of God, In 15, we are just pulled away from the Father and to pulled away to the world. Look at your body. Look at the Jerusalem. Enjoy this. Look at your body. Why are you hungry? Have nice chocolate. Got nothing wrong. Enjoy. Enjoy your body at the cost of moving away from prayer. That's what Satan did to Jesus. Stop praying. He never said. He said, change the stone into bread. A new program, a new direction, a new, which is full of evil, which is oriented to take us away from the presence of God. Yes, that's why David cried in Psalm 51 verse 10, create in me a clean heart, O Lord. Help me that my mind may be fixed on you, Lord. And then he cried, please do not cast me away from your presence. The moment you cast me away from your presence, that is the end of my life. Basically, sin means, as we read in the book of Isaiah, chapter 59, verse 1 to 2. Hello, my dear, you call upon me, Lord, help me. But I am not able to help you. Why? Your sin becomes a wall between you and your God. What is happening to you? By your sin, you are putting a wall between that I should not see you, that I cannot see you. By sin, we put a wall. No, God, I don't need you. I am comfortable here. Please, you don't mind me. You mind your business, Lord. I am happy here. I don't need you. That is called sin. We put a wall between. Yes. We lose. We move away from the presence of God. We move into that which hurts us. That which is impermanent, that which is ugly and evil, that which is sinful. As long as the prodigal son had something of the father, people gave him food. The moment he lost everything of the father, the next moment he was thrown into the pigs. Whatever may be your situation in the world, whatever may be the riches in the world, whatever may be the beauty, whatever may be the education, whatever may be the wealth you have in the world, they are nothing. Nothing in front of the presence of God. Take care that all that God has given to you do not take you away from the presence of God and to give you into the false security, false power. Something having beautiful means you are in the heaven. You have money means you can do anything. No. Sin basically builds around the false power, false knowledge. Yes. That's why in the book of Hosea chapter 4 verse 6, the prophet said, my people are perishing due to lack of knowledge, real knowledge of who they are. So sin basically takes us away from the presence of God. That's why we have a beautiful psalm which says, Psalm 146 verse 4 says, when his spirit departs, man returns to his earth. In that very day, all his plans perish. The moment he loses the presence of God by holding on to something, all my plans which God had kept for me, with a great plan, my God sent me into the world. But when I hold on to sin, moving away from the presence of God, I lose every plan of God. The plan of God perishes. That's what we read in the book of Judges, chapter 16, verse 20. He thought, Samson thought, like any other time, first time I have sinned, nothing happened to me. Second time I have sinned, nothing has happened to me. Now also, he got used to moving away from the presence of God and playing with the world. The Bible says, those of the Bible, can you read? 16:20.
Then she said, the Philistines are upon you, Samson. When he awoke from his sleep,
he thought,
I will go out as at other times.
Like other times, now also, just I will move away from here. He thought, yes.
And shake myself free.
And I will set myself free, he thought.
But he did not know. That the Lord had left him.
You can't play with the sin for long. The Bible says, do not quench your spirit. Do not put the Lord into test. Do not grieve the Holy Spirit who trusted in and stays in you. The Bible wants us, don't play with the sin. Don't hurt the Holy Spirit who has loved you and made your body his temple, and he is staying with you. Don't hurt him. Don't grieve him. And when we hurt the Holy Spirit through our bodies, instead of, as we read in Isaiah 43 verse 7, I have created them to bring glory to me. Instead of bringing glory, throwing away our life for anything and everything, what happens? The Lord's Spirit left Samson. The Lord's Spirit left Samson. The moment the Spirit of the Lord left him, the enemies got the power to catch him, pluck away his eyes, tie his hands and feet with the chains, and Samson died a horrible death. Sin basically means Satan managing to take us away from the presence of God and making us to believe that which is perishing as real and tying us up with that we lose sight of that which is eternal, that which is life-giving. We move away from that which is eternal and life-giving and throw ourselves into that which is perishing, that which is death. That's what Satan could be able to manage to do in the lives of many people.